I'm going to show and explain about my car, where we are now, and what we are going to do in the future. So first of all, I have two M5s, and I have hooked the voltage meters, the bass knobs here, and I have put a loading station here so I can load my phone. This is new from the last season. Also, I have removed my center speakers, and I have only one mid here and tweeter here. They are Digital Designs VOM 6.5 and Digital Designs VOB1s here. I have good stereo image here. It's not that deep because I have so much hard surfaces around, and even the skulls here affect and they reflect the sound, so I get I get peaks at mid-range, so it's not very good sounding, and I've been thinking about foaming this up with some sound absorber. The doors have been also put some sound absorber in it. They had some rattle noises, so everything around there is the sound absorber. It's all good. I'm thinking about maybe using leather here. Everything is green now. Black and green is my new color, and as you can see here, the UV light is also already destroying my color here, so maybe at the end of the summer I will have white skulls. But let's see how it turned out. I have some lights put on inside the box. They are just used by zip ties and zip tie anchors. And I have this music box here that I can control it via radio frequencies here. So I can put whatever color I want or something like that. And that's about it. I have this rock and glue stuff here. It is meant to be in household. I don't know what is sokkeli in English, but this is basically glue and rock, and I have 14 kilograms of this stuff all around here. So it is my sound absorber. Basically what it does, it glues. I glued rock in my floor so I can kill the movement of the metal here and make it more sound-wise better. I did not use a peel and seal or anything sound car audio sound mat or materials, because I wanted to test how this looks, and it has little ripples here and there, and it also is as good as this Raptor bed liner around my car, so it's okay. And then we go at the back, and in here outside I have one sticker only, plus the wheels I have small stickers, but inside here back I have these Digital Designs A5s, and they are on the rubbers here. Another A5, and these are only for the tweeters, so I have 8 tweeters total, and this is 4 channel, and this is 4 channel, so I have, I have a 4 channels in 4 ohms. Every speaker I have in front is in 4 ohms. I have 2 SS4As here. They are also on the rubber, so they are electrically removed from the ground, because I have these rubbers, vulcanite rubber here, and these controls the mids, and I have 6 mids, so I have only I have 2 channels left here to use, but with the 6 mids I can get these are in 4 ohms, I get roughly 140 watts per mid. I have batteries down here, and all my panels are just loose. I will be connecting them properly. I have fuses in every battery, and also I have only 400 amps of fuses in my Digital Designs M5. So these are my main base amps. They are hooked on a rubber also, as you can see here, they wiggle around. And this this rubber helps when the bass is bumping, it helps to absorb the vibrations a lot. So the car is vibrating, but my amps are not. And they are also electrically removed from the ground. Also, but I have a grounding here, of course.
So these give me a roughly 1500 watts. 15,000 watts. I have here a button so I can cut down my main bass amps if shit hits the fan. I have two Helix DSP here, both are 8-channel DSPs, and I've been using DLS Ultimate series wires here, because I have some ground loop issue and some noises from this amp's tweeters. As you can see here, I have my power cable so close to these speaker cables, so I think that these cables are producing electromagnetic field that affects in these wires, and they are getting affected by the, and I have some alternator wire on my right hand tweeters. All the rest of the cables are Aive Silverado series, and underneath here I have my two bus bars. I have plus here and minus here. They are full copper, and every wire is full copper, no aluminium here. I have my front end fuses here, and I have here only 400 amps per M5. And I haven't had any problems with those. These are pretty good amps. What else? Basically, I will be covering all this area here. I will be making some beauty panels here, and I will be covering all the area with foam material so I can get it nice and even everywhere. And that's about it behind here. So let's go to the front and see what's under the hood. So under the hood, I have been replacing my stock alternator and installed a 700 Volvo series alternator bracket here so I can get two alternators. I have 70 amp alternator there and 200 amp alternator. It's made by PowerMax USA, and it's quite hot. So I have two alternator system. I have here a 50 millimeter or zero gauge wiring from the ground side, and another 20 millimeter on the ground side, and 70 millimeter. So this is 220. I don't actually know what it's in English, but 70 millimeter squared cable here. So I have my plus side here, minus side here, and on to the back I have 200 amp relay and 300 amp fuse. Actually, this fuse pops at 120 amps, so this will be replaced, because this every time I bump the bass, this clicks open. So with it, I will be making two of these here, and I have everything in green here. They are just for looks, and that's about it in the front. I have also here a flex fuel. So this car runs in RE85, so that's 85% ethanol and 15% benzene, what the hell it is in English? Gasoline. So I have 85% ethanol and 15% gasoline going through my system. Everything is painted in black. And in the front here, I have made a Volvo 850 lip down here. It is very rough. As you can see, I have some issues here. I will be sanding these down, but I just hook it up and paint it in black fast so I can check how it looks. And I'm quite pleased how it looks. It's really cool. Just adds a little bit. So that's about it about my car now. And in the future, I will be probably put some damp material here, this material here, so I can get it sound wise more better, but it will be the sound pressure will be reduced. So I will be first upgrading my electrical so I can get this 160 dBs. I hope I have now currently with this setup get a 158.5, I think. So I'm 1.5 dBs away from my goal, and if I can get the 160, it's really nice, but if I can't, it's okay to me also. I will be making this more
enjoyable ride. So I will be removing these front seats and making I'm thinking about Dodge Aspen front seat, so I can get a sofa here, which will be black, black leather and some green linings. That would be quite nice. And I will be dampening, making leather here and dampening, making a hair to my skull so I can get the sound reflections damped so much that it does not affect on the sound quality wise. So that's about it about my car now and something about the future. And like if you like, dislike if you dislike, and leave a comment how it looks or what kind of improvements I should be doing on my car. Also, I will be removing my steering wheel. I have a Luisi green steering wheel, but I'm missing the connection piece between here, so it's not hooked up yet. So that's about it. See you on the next video. Bye bye.